understand that I've only got about 5 or 7 minutes, and I want to try and get us back on schedule. But thank you for letting us announce this on behalf of the City of Kansas City, Missouri, Think Big Partners, Cisco, and a whole group of other folks, these Smart Connected City Living Lab, as of today, is actually open for business. So let me just give you a little bit of the backdrop of how we got here and what that means, perhaps, to you. The Smart Connected City project, if you weren't familiar with it, is one of Cisco's largest Smart Connected City projects in the world. It started out as an idea in 2014, and over the course of 2 years and a lot of hard work by a number of folks, as Bob Bennett makes his way over here as well, the number of hours that he put in, and then his predecessor put in, and then Mayor James, and City Manager Troy Schulte, and all the different departments, and Cisco, and Sprint, and so many more people that we can even talk about. The idea was, how do we help address the urbanization problems? If you're not familiar with it, 3 million people a week are moving into cities. And although about 54% of the world's population today lives in a city, the next 20 years that's gonna grow and swell to about 60-65%. That's not a bad thing. Cities are trying to become more vibrant, more dense, and with more density, economic prosperity occurs, but traffic, water, public safety, crime, power grid, things, small things, hardly worth mentioning, become stressed. The infrastructure here in Kansas City is already aging enough, and then you now overstress it. Really, the Smart City project was designed to be able to address things like public safety, traffic, transportation, mobility, and not just technology, sensors, and beacons, but really talking about digital divide, digital inclusion, vibrancy, education. I mean, all the things that makes a smart city. What's even a smart city? You know, the definitions are numerous. So this project really was twofold. The project went live in 2016, but the second piece of this is the innovation lab. Because if you are looking at the technology that's coming today from all these large companies or out of garages, and both technology stacks can be very, very vital, it's very hard for a city manager to be able to make a decision to be able to buy something when it's emerging and it even overworks. And so the idea of the innovation lab and the living lab is essentially a public-private partnership once again, not just the $15.7 million public-private partnership that we started with, the opportunity to be able to commercialize technology, looking at civic problems, looking at technology solutions, creating partnerships based on connectivity, and this conference is all about connectivity. But the connectivity between ideas, problems, solutions, partners, and how do we move these faster through. So Cisco has a DevNet portal. You can access a ton of data. You can look at real data sets from all these different assets, whether they're kiosks or lights or optical sensors. It could be the streetcar in Kansas City. It could be other things. But be able to look at the data that's flowing off these sensors, be able to build, test these things, the regression analysis, be able to understand and validate the technology that you built, that helps this technology get into the commercial marketplace. And that's where you can start making a difference on the 3 million people living in the cities each week. There's more to it. There's the partnership with the city, the ability to have a constant dialogue with the stakeholders in Kansas City, which, by the way, Kansas City's problems are much like all the other problems around the country. Water, public safety, infrastructure, all these things. I heard a quote once, you know, the average Parisian spends 8 years of their life stuck in traffic and looking for a parking space. Isn't that not horrible? So it's not just the traffic, it's the pollution, it's the safety, it's the mobility, it's the people going to and from work, the first and last mile, all that is connected. So the Living Lab connects the DevNet portal, the data streams, the ability to have a dialogue with the city and the stakeholders. Then you get access to the Fortune 1000 companies, and a lot of Fortune 100 companies that are building these products and are looking for opportunities to partner with emerging technology, and then all the other providers and service players that are surrounding it. Connectivity is an incredibly vital piece. So all this goes live. If you are interested in more information, you can find out this afternoon between 2 and 2:30. We're here. There's a website, kansascitylivinglab.org, not .com. There's a webinar scheduled 2 weeks from today that we'll be able to give more details. And it's a really nice way for us to be able to transition the smart city aspirations of Kansas City, the innovation partnering, solving problems, and even the innovation partnership program that Kansas City has. Where Kansas City now for several years has been taking emerging technologies, looking for real-life test cases, installing it inside of processes and systems and infrastructure, and then figuring out if it works. That, to me, solves the problems. That's what the Living Lab is all about. I appreciate your time and attention. This has been a great conference and a hard act to follow, especially after the connectivity, but I bet there's connectors in that book that we just talked about that you'll find already working in the Living Lab, and our goal is not only to do it here in Kansas City, but if you're from other cities, the ability to grow and scale it, because the ability to commercialize technology, create the dial tone of innovation, is really important, and if we can work with other cities, we can all move faster solving all of our problems collectively too. So with that, thank you very much.